B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to make a DIY temperature-controlled fan using Arduino Nano and a 5-volt relay. Welcome back. I wanted to go ahead and do this video because I tore apart an old computer and I salvaged most everything in it, but one of the items I salvaged was a fan. I actually got two. And I want to turn that fan into a project. Well, with that said, let's begin. In this video, I used a whole bunch of male-to-male jumper wires. I also used two LEDs, one red, one green, with a 220-ohm resistor as well attached to each. I also have a 10,000-ohm resistor right here. And then here is my thermistor. That's what's going to be determining what the temperature is. That came in the Elegoo kit. So if you got the kit, it's in that. You can also buy it separately. Over here I've got the Arduino Nano. And I've got the breakout board, which I love. So I'm using that as well. Over here I've got the 5-volt relay. And then attached to that I have a 9-volt battery. It's rechargeable. It's pretty small. It's 250 milliamp hour, but it is awesome. I like it. I use it all the time. And I just have a 9-volt adapter so that I can plug that into my breadboard here and then into the relay. And then I have the fan that I got from the computer. Here's a closer look at the fan. It is a 12-volt fan, but I'll be operating it with 9 volts. And as you can see, it has 4 leads coming out of the motor here. As we look back here, we're not going to use all 4 because we just want to turn it off and turn it on using the 5-volt relay here, the coil. When you activate the coil, we're just going to power it on and off. So we want the positive and negative leads, and that's all we'll be using. And you also want to use, of course, the strawberry pound cake candle.
Man, that smells delicious. Pound cake.
Right, that doesn't have to be strawberry pound cake, but I did use a Christmas tree scented candle earlier, and it kind of gave me a headache, so I'll use this one. You'll also need a breadboard. You can use two, but I'm just using one. So the wiring for my microcontroller is over here. And then also the wiring for the fan is right here. It's not attached to the other wiring. So you could use a second breadboard for this if you want. I chose not to. But that's all you'll need.
Here's a look at the wiring. Over here we have the 5-volt and the ground, and they are just connected to the positive and negative rail of the breadboard right here. Over here we have the A0, which is the analog zero pin, and it is connected to one leg of the thermistor right here. And on the back side of that leg, you have a 10,000 ohm resistor connecting it to the ground rail of the breadboard. And the other leg of the thermistor here is connected to the 5-volt positive rail of the breadboard. On the other side of the microcontroller, we have digital pins 3, 4, and 5. So digital pin 3 is the black wire, and it is connected to the green LED. I use these LEDs as indicators for what's going on with the relay. And so the black wire is connected to the positive side, the long pin of the green LED. The short pin, the negative pin or ground pin of the LED, is connected to the ground rail with a 220 ohm resistor. Pin 4 is the blue wire here, and it's connected to the long pin or the positive pin of the red LED, and the short leg of the LED, the negative or ground pin, is connected to the negative rail or the ground rail of the breadboard with a 220 ohm resistor right here. Digital pin 5 is the orange wire here, and it's connected to my 1N port on my relay, and it is my fan pin So the middle port is a negative, and then the bottom port here, or the left port, is with the white wire, is the positive. On the other side, we have three ports labeled NO, COM, and NC. The NO, normally open port, is connected to the positive wire for my battery, my 9-volt battery. So the negative wire from the battery is connected to the ground wire of the fan, and I did that using the breadboard right here. And it's connected to this black wire, which is hooked onto the ground wire of the fan right here. So the green wire here is connected to the positive wire of my fan, which is this yellow cord coming out of the fan. And I've got it connected to the breadboard here, which is also connected to the COM port, the middle port, the common port of the relay. So that's the wiring for this setup. If you didn't catch all that, I've included the schematic here, and hopefully this schematic will help you make sense of the connections. This is the 5-volt relay. If you're not familiar with the relay module, I'll go ahead and tell you the really neat thing about it is this guy right here is an optocoupler, and it allows an electronic signal to pass between two isolated circuits. As indicated right here, 5-volt DC. This is your 5-volt side right here. And this side makes it perfect for Arduino, 5-volt Arduino power, or also breadboard power supply using a 5-volt wall adapter, or just a regular battery hookup with 5 volts. And this is kept totally separate from this side, which is a much higher voltage, as indicated down here. You can go up to 250 volts AC at 10 amp. You can also do 125 volts AC at 15 amps. Today we're going to use 9 volts, far cry from that, but it will be a separate circuit from the 5 volt over here. If you turn the module this way, you can see that there's three ports on the 5 volt side, and it is D plus, D minus. That's where your positive and your negative wires will go for your power supply, and then the one in will be for the fan pin to operate the fan. Now this says one in because it is a single channel relay. They also sell 2-channel, 4-channel, 8-channel, 16-channel, and I think maybe even 32-channel. But each channel has its own setup, just like you see here, with a relay in the middle here, and your ports for the circuits on either side, separated by an optocoupler. So this is a single channel. They also sell it in 12 volt. This is 5 volt. They also sell it in 12 volt. They sell it in 24 volt, and I believe 32 volt, but I'm not sure about that. Now, if you had a 12 volt, you would have to supply 12 volts of power through this side at the DC plus and DC minus. If you had a 24 volt, you'd have to likewise supply 24 volts of power through this side to activate the relay coil, which is in the relay right here. We are going to use 5 volts from the Arduino to activate the 5 volt coil right here in the relay in order to close the normally open circuit so that the fan will turn on. Now on this side, the much higher voltage side, or capable of entertaining higher voltage, is this side, and it'll be labeled NO for normally open, COM for common, and NC for normally closed. Today we're using normally open and common because we want the fan to be off at its regular state, and then once the coil is activated, it'll close that circuit, turn the fan on. But today we're using normally open and common. So if you're going to connect it to the higher voltage AC, I would encourage you to mount this to something that's not conductive, such as wood. I usually mount it to wood, and also isolate it with an electronic junction box just to keep it covered so that everyone's safe. You don't want to touch this anywhere if you are connecting it to AC power supply. This is a thermistor. This is the same thermistor that came with the Elegoo Mega Kit, and it does have two pins. The thermistor is a resistance thermometer, so as the temperature increases, the resistance in this increases. As the temperature decreases, the resistance decreases. And you'll see that with the temperature on the serial monitor for our project today. We're going to hang this over top of a candle, and as the flame from the candle warms the air around this, you will see a temperature increase because the resistance in the thermistor is increasing. These are often used in electronic devices automobiles, digital thermometers, electronics. So if you pull one apart, you may see one of these. And you'll notice it has two pins. It's a two-pin connector here, and there is no polarity, meaning there's no positive and negative value with each leg. So that is, in a nutshell, a thermistor. So here's the code from our project. We'll come up here, and immediately we define the fan pin at pin 5, and the green and red LED pins at pin 3 and 4, digital pin 3 and 4. We come down here, and the thermistor is at analog 0, and we also declare an integer of V0, which you can see down here, V0 is the analog read of the thermistor pin, which is analog 0, that's what that is. And these values right here are just are used in calculating the Fahrenheit of the temperature, which you'll see down here in the loop. That's all that is. Come down here to setup, and we'll say that fan pin, the red and green LED are all outputs, and I stuck the serial monitor code right there in between them. I come down here to loop, and so V0, I already mentioned that. Here you're calculating the Fahrenheit temperature of your thermistor, what it detects, and then down here you're telling your serial monitor to print the temperature. Here you're telling your monitor to print the value and F for Fahrenheit. Down here we have an if-else statement, and it says if the temperature is greater than 74, we'll turn the fan on, the red LED on, and the green LED off. And if it is less than 74 degrees, we will turn the fan off, the red LED off, and the green LED on. So that's it for this. I did have to look this part up right here on the Arduino forums. So that's where I got that from. Mine wasn't working quite as well. It was giving me a really weird number, much lower than I expected it to be for Fahrenheit. But this worked out really nice. And like I said, I got that on one of the forums. So that's it for this code.
As you can see, the fan keeps coming on once the thermistor reaches a temperature greater than 74, according to the code. And you can see that once it gets over 74, the fan will turn on until the thermistor cools down lower than 74. And in the code, right there, I put the temperature at 74 degrees. So once it hits that, that is the trigger for the fan to come on. And I set it so that it can't blow the candle out, so I don't have to continually relight it. But it is heating the thermistor right here. And it's heating it quite frequently.
Well, that's all I've got for today. If you happen to make this, let me know how it went. And as always, thank you very much for watching. My name's Brad, and I'll see you again very soon.